Friedman test in SPSS. Friedman test is a non-parametric test alternative to repeated measure of ANOVA. We use it when we want to find the mean difference of measurement at three or more different time points or conditions from same sample, given that data is not normally distributed or the dependent variable is ordinal in nature. Let's see an example how we can perform Friedman test in SPSS. This is a SPSS file, and you see we have three variable, and this is the variable view and this is the data view. In this example, what we are trying to do, we are trying to perform Friedman test based on the given example here. The example that we are talking here is about that a researcher actually wants to see the impact and efficacy of different antiviral drug on prevention of flu virus. So this researcher has three drug against the flu virus, drug 1, drug 2, and drug 3. And the same drug has been used on 2,380 participants. And this researcher actually wants to see whether there is difference on the effectiveness of the drug for the prevention of the flu virus. Now, the reason I am using Friedman test here is that we have three or more conditions, so at least we have three conditions here, right? So this is the one pre-criteria for using the Friedman test. And another pre-criteria is that your dependent variable should be an ordinal or your data is not normally distributed. So in my case, my data is not normally distributed and I want to compare the mean difference from same sample at three different conditions. Now, to perform the Friedman test, I need to press analyze and then non-parametric test. However, in the SPSS, we can perform Friedman test in two ways. One is that through legacy dialog. Another one is using the related sample. So if I use the legacy dialog, so if you click the legacy dialog, and then if you need to click on the K-related sample, and these are your three drugs, so drug 1, drug 2, drug 3, and their efficacy rate is given in your data file. So I need to put these three conditions or three drug under the test variable. And test type, I can click the Friedman, it is already given, but if it is not ticked before, then you need to tick that one and you need to press OK. Now, from this table, you can see that the mean ranking of these three drug, and from this table, I can see that the highest efficacy is for the drug 3, which is 2.20. And then drug 2 and then drug 1. Okay, so this is the mean ranking from lowest to the highest. And the efficacy of these three drugs actually significantly differ, because if you see the p-value of this chi-square, so this p-value is statistically significant because it is less than 1%. The problem of this legacy dialog options for using the Friedman test is that it only gives you the mean ranking and whether the difference is statistically significant or not, but it will not give you the result of the mean difference between whether the mean difference between the different groups are statistically significant or not. So if I want to find out a pairwise difference, then the better option using the related sample. So to perform the related sample, you need to go analyze non-parametric test and click related sample. Now you see there are three options: objectives, fields, and settings. So click on the fields, and from here under the field, so you need to put all these three variables under the test field. So click that arrow and it will go to this test field box. And you see in the below there is option run. Click the run. And if you click the run, then you will get the result of the non-parametric test. And the good thing is that it is actually explaining your hypothesis. That means, you know, the significance level, the p-value, it is actually less than your significance level. So the decision here is that reject the null hypothesis. And that means there is significant difference between the efficacy of these three different types of drugs for the prevention of flu virus. Now you need to double click, on this box. Okay, so if you double click on this box, then further you will get the mean ranking of all these three drugs. And this is the test statistics and the p-value. Now we want to see the pairwise difference. So to do that, in the below of this table, you see there is option of test Friedman, and in the right hand side there is option field, and after the field there is option of view. So to find the pairwise difference, you need to click on the view options. So under the view there are three options. You need to click on the pairwise comparison. Now if you click the pairwise comparison, you will get a plot. This plot that we are seeing here, this actually shows the mean rank. You see the mean rank, efficacy of each drug. And the orange line, this orange line actually connects or joins significantly different pair. Okay, now to see the significant difference in the pair, I need to look at the below table. So it is highlighted by the orange color. So basically, if you see, there is no significant difference on the efficacy of drug 1 and drug 2, okay? However, there is significant difference on the efficacy between drug 1 and drug 3 and drug 2 and drug 3. And you see the p-value, it is actually statistically significant. And if I look at this value, you can simply see this is actually test statistic, but we need to adjust this. So you need to actually use the standard test statistics value for the reporting purpose. Okay, and based on that I got our adjusted significant. And this pair is not statistically significant, however the difference between drug 1 and drug 3 and drug 2 and drug 3 is statistically significant. And as I shown earlier, that the efficacy between these three drugs, the highest efficacy is for the drug 3. Okay, right. So in this way, we can perform Friedman test in the SPSS.